The new association says its primary role will be to act as a voice on behalf of members on issues of social justice and human rights, social change and advocacy.
Social workers deal with so many difficulties that people have, whether it be familial, individual, trauma, abuse and neglect, that they have to have a place where the collective voice is, can talk out on some issues, can address concerns that are huger than the one thing. So like if you see 5-10 families a week and you're seeing some trends, an association allows you to talk to those trends in a way that's not always possible.
Apart from the benefits to the members, the hope is that the formation of the association will also benefit the government and other organizations by giving them a resource to which to turn for help to address a number of social and other issues affecting the society.
Ideally, once people are involved in some kind of trauma response, there should usually be what's called a debriefing process, as you correctly said. And that is an opportunity to yourself work through the information that you've had. And that allows us to, as it is, recover, if you wish, and helps us to be okay, basically. And debriefing is a critical part of self-care, a critical part of making us well to be able to continue the work that we do.
The expectation is that the association will help raise the profile and image of the profession. This will in turn ensure that people using social work services can have faith in the professionals entrusted to work with them.